Takže já se jmenuji Dusan Rak.
Hello, my name is Dusan Rak and I'm responsible for the Anitra System company and the Anitra brand. We founded this company as a vessel for various technological solutions, things we were developing for a long time on an amateur level. Everything related to monitoring, so-called telemetry, of birds and other animals. Our main line of products are GPS loggers, devices able to track the animal position, which send the data via a cell phone network, basically from anywhere in the world. Usually they are charged with solar panels. These devices come in different shapes, some of them as a ring worn on a bird's leg. Mostly though, they are like small backpacks strapped to the bird's back via loops around their neck, wings or legs. We are trying to fill a certain technological gap on the market, provide solutions for various situations and species. Because every species is a bit different, there are different requirements, like the maximum weight of the device. Some species, like owls, for example, are nocturnal or reclusive. Therefore, we have to use a non-rechargeable battery instead of the solar panel. The device then works only for a limited period and can be designed to fall off after some time. Because there are so many shapes and we always try new things, for developing and testing new designs, we cooperate with people from various animal rescue centers who let us test the new devices in action on birds that are caged but usually to be released eventually. And because we always make a lot of changes in the early stages, 3D printing is really helpful. We can be flexible, we can implement the changes very quickly and test everything on the caged birds immediately. Sometimes we even use the 3D prints for the actual manufacturing, although 3D prints have their weaknesses compared to the classic injection plastic, which can be made more accurate, lighter and also more waterproof. However, for the early trial and error stages, 3D printing is really helpful. Of all the filament materials we tried, ASA seems to be the most suitable. Compared to most other materials, it is resistant to sunshine and other environmental factors. ASA is a lightweight styrene-based plastic. It is tough and it can withstand some rough handling. We tried some other more advanced materials like polycarbonate, however printing with them is more tricky and also it's not as easy to glue polycarbonate parts together. They cannot be simply glued with acetone like ASA. We still try to explore other options, but as of now, ASA seems to be the optimal solution. It is a lightweight material and its low density is obviously a big advantage, especially for the birds. When we place various loggers into colors worn, for example, by deer or lynxes, we can get away with the heavier stuff. For flying birds, though, there is a sort of an ethical boundary, more or less accepted within the scientific community, that the bird shouldn't carry a load greater than 3% of its body weight, so the device isn't a burden for them. This is not too limiting for larger species. For example, that stork you see now could easily carry a much heavier logger. The minimum weight we can reach with all the technology plus battery is about 10 grams. This means the smallest bird which can carry the logger is the size of a common kestrel. For all species smaller than that, this technology is not suitable and other tracking methods, often less flexible, have to be used. This stork here is a youngster who probably suffered from an accident during the period of leaving the nest on a tall chimney as he was found nearby. Here we checked him and gave him medical treatment and now he will carry this tracking device, so we know his position in the upcoming days. Later we can see where he flies, what he does and where he makes stops. When we track multiple birds over a longer period of time, we can identify dangerous locations. It is not a secret that in the Middle East, the migrating birds are shot basically for fun. Different species are hunted in Malta, Sicily or Italy, also for fun, but for meat as well. In Africa, obviously, mostly as a food source. It is possible to identify the bottlenecks through which most of the population travels. If some of the threat factors are present there, it can do a lot of harm. So this is the main point of this research, to see where the birds go and what dangers could be there. Our technology is focused on monitoring the movement of animals, so-called telemetry in scientific terminology. The logger collects data at pre-programmed intervals, say once every hour or every 5 minutes. It depends on the species, what we can afford, considering how much energy the battery gets from the sunshine. The location can be identified anywhere, as long as there is an open sky, so the logger can reach the GPS satellites. Sometimes the conditions are worse, for example next to buildings or trees. Together with latitude and longitude, it also measures altitude, temperature, there are three-axis sensors, accelerometer, magnetometer and a gyroscope. With them, we can monitor how the bird tilts during the flight, his style of movement and the amount of activity during the day. We have inbuilt algorithms checking the life functions, so if there is a problem, the logger is proactive, it doesn't wait for the regular schedule, like sending the data for example once a day. In fact, it can send us a warning immediately. That means we can start to investigate right away. If the bird is not dead, but merely injured and immobile, we can still try to help. As for the dead birds, many times an illegal activity, for example shooting or poisoning birds of prey, has to be investigated in cooperation with the police. Speed matters in these cases, because there is a tendency to cover the tracks. So everything has to be documented as soon as possible.